I'm a relationship therapist for individuals, but a relationship strategist for companies. And I have to talk relationship therapy almost, or relationship interactions, personal relationship interactions on the business side, because somehow they always impact, one always impacts the other. And as a matter of fact, I gave an example in the book in the very beginning of this man that I worked with who was just, I mean, he was going through an awful divorce and yet he needed to get his stuff out there. And he was, his divorce was read all over his body language.
Right.
And so I, if not for the work that I was able to do with him to get him over that hurdle and then to lead him to the business part of the communications, he would never have done as quickly as he had done where he had to go to. He would never have gotten to where the destination was that quickly.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was glad that I had that in my background. One without the other, I don't think is as helpful as having both those skills on the personal relationship side and the professional relationship side.
Yeah, I think those are critical skills. And as we're talking about these things, I had some other thing that came to mind while you're talking about this I wanted to talk about today. I thought was really interesting.
Good.
Communication comes into play in so many different ways, right? And I was thinking about it when I interviewed the CEO of a big virtual reality startup that was so fascinating to me. It was Prisms VR. It was teaching kids different kinds of STEM skills, you know, science, technology,
right,
engineering, and math for anybody I know you know, but if other people don't, that they were using like an Oculus, you know, virtual reality kind of, you know, of course I have because I'm a tech.
Of course, I know. You have to have all your techie stuff.
I'm telling you, I'm not affiliated with any of this Oculus stuff, but it's the coolest thing ever. Okay, so you put these things on your head, right, to look at, and but anyway, so they're communicating to these children math by having them visualize what it is. Instead of giving you a math problem, they're giving you, look at, watch people spread COVID and look at ghosts exponentially or whatever it is that they're picking, right? That was an example she gave. But I'm wondering how much communication we're going to have through these virtual reality kinds of systems, that's going to be the next chapter you're going to have to add to your book.
Oh.
You have to create your own code.
you're so right.
An avatar within your software. Because then you don't, you know, now we're just pick my lipstick red on the screen, but you might pick your whole person pretty soon where we don't have to get ready. And we'll be equal with the men. We'll take as much time to get ready at that point. But, you know, I'm thinking that this might be the future way we communicate to some extent. And this is kind of getting that way with Zoom right now, where some people are adjusting the different, you know, hats and flowers and stuff. Yeah. Uh-huh. You know, so how you present yourself in the new technology realm is going to be an interesting way. Because, you know, when I taught initially in online education, one of the first classes I taught them was netiquette, how to, you know, have internet etiquette, basically, of not typing in all caps, not, you know, because that means you're yelling, and not doing certain things because it means something different. So it's going to be interesting to see what what everything means.
But here is the issue. We are definitely dependent upon our interaction online. There's no question about it. And the pandemic really pushed us over the edge to get there. However, what happens when we're not in front of the computer? I worry about that because, granted,
like texting, though. People said that about texting, that nobody was going to be able to talk again.
And well, they can't.
To some extent.
well, seriously, they can't. And we're having all kinds of difficulties with their communication skills in corporate America as a result of that. And I think that I worry that what happens when the companies say, fine, we're not going to have you at the office every single day, and that's quite all right. So a lot of companies are saying, instead of the totally virtual, a lot of companies are opting for hybrids.
So
what does that mean? That does mean that when you see somebody for the first time in a very long time, you have that one moment to make or break that impression that will gain you promotions and raises of all kinds, because you have got to make that impact. And it's no different from all the years that we've been talking about how to be a great conversationalist, how to make your point and then go on. I talk about the EDM, my invented EDM technique, ialogue, then dialogue, then your monologue about who you are, because you've got to soften that. These skills do not exist.
Yeah.
And I worry about that.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how, you know, there used to be the women weren't involved when the guys would play golf or went to the happy hours, the highballs and the, you know, all that stuff. And then they were, and then now certain people are not as tech savvy as others, or there's people are connecting in different ways now. And the people, the way you got promoted, you know, being in this click, what's the click now?
We don't know that. That's the interesting part. That's so fascinating to me as both a researcher and a writer and a presenter and all of things all at once.
Right.
I'm very interested in seeing the next generation of what happens, because I know now that our communication skills are lacking. I know now that the kids are more dependent upon their devices for communications than they ought to be. Oh, I'm not saying I don't like it. I love our devices and I'm dependent upon my own. However, we have to also be able to shed that and be in person. Because in the end, not only are we presenting for our professional public, but it's those communication skills that will take us into our own home lives. And to have an adequate work-life balance, we are going to have to be able to be as strong in our life part as we are in our work part, even though that is online.